And on the iHeartRadio app, you can always leave us messages there.
Alan, a retention pond or stormwater basin is a body of water to help with storm, aka rainwater management. You buckle.
Rainwater. Did he call me a bunghole? Is that what he did?
I think so. I feel like that I got cut off, though.
Oh, God. I think he called me a bunghole. Thank you. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. Well, listen, that horse died at that retention pond out there in Northfield Park. People are telling me that apparently it ran off with all of its harness gear on.
And that must have weighed it down.
Yes. So thank you for that message, sir.
You can take me, but you cannot take my bunghole.
Mary, right. Do you know what song this is?
A dumb Kate Bush song.
No.
Oh, what?
Not Kate Bush.
Q Lazarus.
No.
And it's called Goodbye Horses.
Oh, good.
That's
good one.
The joke.
Good one.
That's the...
This is the song that a lot of people associate with the Silence of the Lambs when Buffalo Bill, Parma, Ohio's own Ted Levine, when he was tucking and dancing in front of the mirror, Goodbye Horses was the song that was playing.
Much different movie if he was called Billy Buffalo. Just, he doesn't sound as intimidating.
Right.
Old Billy Buffalo.
Mm-hmm. Billy Buffalo. Whatever happened to Q Lazarus? She had this song, and then, man, she was just gone.
One-hit wonder.
I guess so. Diane Lucky was her
real
name.
That's why it's a one-hit wonder, because you wonder where they went. Hilarities this Saturday.
If you want real jokes, you could come to
Hilarities this Saturday.
Brothers Lounge tonight.
Are you implying that at a Bill Squire show, there are no real laughs?
All I'm saying is...
Like that one?
That's a very
real
laugh.
A real laugh. Mm. I collected a group of people in the hallway to spontaneously
There's
laugh.
There's always random people here. Mm-hmm. Especially these
Ready
days.
So many randos.
Ready to laugh.
So I got
to
bring them in.
I mean, there's being... At Stand and Deliver, at Hilarities, there's jokes being written that night. And guess who gives them the topics? It's not other comedians. It's the audience members.
Oh, is it great?
It's the best.
Sounds good. Yeah. Well, if you want to just go enjoy a show and not participate in it, you can come to Brothers Lounge at 8 p.m.
Oh, snap. You're saying if you want to
be entertained.
If you want to be a passive participant.
If you don't want homework
you don't want
out
stakes.
Of your entertainment.
You don't want there to be stakes.
Brothers Lounge,
it.
8 p.m. tonight.
Speaking of Hilarities, Andy Haynes is going to be on the show tomorrow.
I'm working with him on Sunday.
I think he's a very underrated comedian. I was supposed to have his wife on here a few weeks ago, but she's shooting something. He's married to Rose Baker. And so he will be on the show tomorrow. I'm going to have him call in. For people who aren't familiar with him, I'd like you to be familiar with him because I think he's very funny.
And he's doing
Sunday night at Hilarities with one Bill Squire.
That's right. A lot of prepared jokes from that guy.
Q Lazarus now works as a bus driver in Staten Island, having retired from the music business.
All right.
She put out an album in the early 90s before Jonathan Demme got a hold of Goodbye Horses. That song was from the 80s. The record companies kept turning her away because they said they couldn't market her due to her dreadlocks. Oh, yeah. You know, because black artists never had dreadlocks, so the record companies had no clue what to do. Hey, Q Lazarus drove my bus!
Here's my stop.
Hey, Staten Island! That's where Colin Jost's house was! Pete Davidson! Hey!
The Impractical Jokers!
That's right!
I think that's all!
The Verrazano Bridge!
Is that Staten Island?
Yeah, doesn't that connect Staten Island to Brooklyn?
I don't know.
Yeah. Anywho, I could be wrong.
I thought it was all fairies. Maybe not.
The fairy.
I didn't have that ready.
Come on, dude.
I'm sorry.
Come on, Staten Island. What else would you need?
Oh, yeah, it's Verrazano.
You ferry.
There it is.
Yeah!
If you want to get to Manhattan, I think you got to take the ferry.
Yeah.
Nothing like timing, eh?
But if you want to take a bridge, hey!
Verrazano!
Verrazano Narrows! Poundcake is going to be back tomorrow. Next. What?
So when he's back tomorrow, I'm going to send you a clip of a friend of ours that said something. This is a smart guy, too. That said a Poundcake-ism.
Ooh.
I'm very excited to play it.
Okay.
Oh, just something he picked up from Poundcake? Or
no.
This is a guy, he's got his own podcast. He said it on his podcast. I was listening. I was like, holy crap.
A scapegoat?
Nah.
And then when I got a big load, I go put it in there.
Hang around to drive?
Nope. You'll see tomorrow. I'll send it to Alan. He'll play it on the show.
Her family hung her out to drive. GameStop was just like their scapegoat, I guess.
Oh, poor Cody.
Poor Cody?
Yeah.
He's a grown man that doesn't know escape goat is not a thing.
Now that I think about it,
he hung me out to drive.
He didn't say it exactly the same way as Poundcake, but he said it wrong. And so...
That's what's important.
Is this a well-known podcaster?
Yeah. He's been on the show before.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, next week on the show, I'll have tickets for you if you want to go see Gary Clark Jr. He's dynamite. He's playing MGM Northfield Park in September. Incubus and Rome, Sublime with Rome, are going to play August of Blossom, all of those. If you want to go to the Concert for Legends, that's the thing they do out at the Hall of Fame in Canton. It's Journey. That is August 6th. And then Highly Suspect, that's a great band too. That I don't think gets enough attention.
Canadian, right?
Highly Suspect?
Aren't they?
I thought they were British. I might be thinking of someone else.
I'm thinking of Widespread Panic. That's the...
Oh, okay. Highly Suspect is from outside Boston, I think.
Is Widespread Panic, is that the...
I don't know who you're thinking of. Are you thinking of... No, Widespread Panic is like an Atlanta band, I think.
What the hell?
Are you thinking of OAR?
Not OAR.
That's not a Canadian band either. You're thinking of a Canadian band?
Canadian band.
No.
Maybe they're just big in Canada.
A lot of bands. The Tragically Hip?
That's it.
Gord Downie, R.I.P.?
That's the one.
Tragically Hip.
The Tragically Hip.
Right.
Bands all got names that just run together for me.
Messages coming through on the talkback button on the iHeartRadio app.
Hello. Lenny Mesa, Bureau Chief. Just want to call because... I heard you say, no body, no crime. I believe that's a Bob Marley song, but I could be wrong. Okay, love you. Bye.
Bye. No body, no crime. Yeah, he was right. Bob Marley, little known fact, in his younger days, before he really got into music, was killing a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
Softly.
And some of them hardly. He was very hardly killing people. So it was right around the time he had a band when he was young called the Teenagers. It was him and Peter Tosh and Bunny Wailer. And he was running around killing people. And so when he got sick and died, some people thought that it was a form of karma, right? Boy, imagine that. You've got this career going. Bob Marley died from cancer as a young man. It was like the early 80s when he died. He was 36, Bob Marley, when he died. And he got melanoma.
That's younger than Mary plays in movies.
It is. It's younger than my casting age.
Uh-huh.
Hey, the Chrysler Building!
Yo, Times Square!
Hey, Holland Tunnel over
here! Hey, Applebee's!
Bob Marley got melanoma under a toenail.
Yeah.
And died.
Sing it.
No body, no crime.
You got it.
Right. His last concert was in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. So you're like, hey, remember when we went to go see Bob Marley?
I remember that day.
He died a couple of days after that show at the old Stanley Theater.
Yeah, dirty toenail.
Yeah, the Stanley P. Kachowski Theater. Now it's the Benedum Center. But he was there. We looked at him, we go, Bob, you feeling all right? He goes, I don't know. I think I got cancer in a toenail. And that's what happened. That's what it did to him. Give you some money here. It's a last chance today. So I want you to take a breath. I want you to clear your mind. I want you to center yourself. Because somebody's going to win. I hope it's you.
Focus.
Focus. With all you got in you. For this $1,000. Last chance to win today. Good luck.
The Buzzard wants you to go fuel yourself and score $1,000. Enter the nationwide keyword credit at WMMS.com. That's credit. Enter it now at WMMS.com. And good luck from Buzzard Radio.
Alan, T-Rat on the road again. You definitely are a moron. The horse was just coming into its own identity and felt it was a seahorse. That's why it drowned.
What?
It was a, I think it was a pun. Seahorse drowning.
Duh. Listen, I don't like anybody. If it's a seahorse and it was male, maybe it was pregnant.
Might have been. That is a legal fish law abortion.
When a male seahorse terminates itself. Drowns itself. Right. All right. A dude, now, I don't know that they confirmed that it was because of this, but if it wasn't because of this, this is a crazy, unfortunate coincidence. A guy trying to win a $12 bet chugs an entire bottle of Jaegermeister and dies a few minutes later.
Dies the happiest man.
Jaeger is a very disgusting, divisive liquor. This is a guy in North Africa, in Limpopo. Where's Limpopo, Bill?
It's in North Africa.
It is?
According
Let
to
me see if you are correct.
To your sources.
Limpopo. It's in Botswana. Oh, it's a it's a province near Botswana. So, yeah, it's South Africa, right? It's the northernmost part. Of South Africa.
Okay, so northern,
so if you
South
live
Africa,
there,
yeah. Like I said, northern South Africa.
Right.
It's
so,
just there.
Mm-hmm. So this guy calls the Limpopo, and they...
That's the sound of the police!
This guy tries to win a $12 bet by drinking an entire... The video is online, by the way. Before he died, you can... The video went viral of this guy chugging a bottle of Jägermeister. In a drinking competition at a bar. This is a few minutes before midnight. I love the name of the bar. It's called the Blue Corner Car Wash and Liquor Restaurant.
I'd go there.
Yeah, there's probably something lost in translation there. But this guy drank an entire bottle of Jaeger.
For 12 bucks.
He wanted to win $12, which in Limpopo... Might be really
That's the sound of the police.
Might be really, really good money. He drank the whole bottle in one continuous chug in under 2 minutes and then proceeded to promptly pass out. Everybody around him's going crazy, obviously, because they didn't think he could do it. He passed out and then he died from that. Now, is this good or bad press for Jägermeister?
Not great, probably.
I mean, it doesn't come back on them. You know, I mean...
They just don't drink a whole bottle.
Yeah, of course. I mean, every liquor company has got, you know, they get a free pass because it's not their fault what people do. But what if it was coincidental? What if this guy had some underlying congenital situation he didn't realize was happening?
That would be triggered...
By Jägermeister.
An entire bottle of Jägermeister.
This guy goes, listen.
I guess we'll never know.
You know what I like to drink. I need an alcohol that's made with dozens of herbs and spices. I want the liquid alcohol equivalent of the Colonel's chicken. Right? Those Germans, they know how to make a digestif. And so this guy goes, hey. Give me that bottle of Jaeger. Now, since it's out of a bottle, I bet it wasn't chilled.
Ugh, no.
You know, people like the Jaeger machine.
Unless he put his head under the machine and just cranked it. But also, I mean, you're dying and you're having one really bad brain freeze.
Yeah, I don't mind Jaeger. But the thought of drinking an entire bottle makes me shiver.
Once in a while, Jaeger. is kind of fun.
35% ABV in Jaeger. This guy drank an entire bottle for $12. Well, here is the final indignity. You're never going to believe this. The kicker? Didn't get the money because he died.
Oh. Yeah, because he's dead.
Didn't get to enjoy.
They're about to send it through Venmo, and then they die. And like, well, so what's in there?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Hey, send that to me through Limpopo Pay.
That's the sound of the police.
Yeah. So, yeah, listen, Jaeger has been around a long time. That's a testament to the fortitude of the German people, right? Pre-Weimar Republic. Maybe during. Who knows? Wilhelm and Kurt Mast were the guys that created Jägermeister, and it has not changed at all since it was invented in the early 20th century. The guys who made it were vinegar manufacturers. That's where these guys were coming from. They were like, what if we made something that didn't, that we take vinegar and make it something people could drink, but it would, they could have after dinner or before dinner.
Did you always hear the rumor that it had deer's blood in it?
Oh yeah, elk blood.
That's why it
had
the deer on it.
That's right.
Can't drink that man's deer blood.
What makes you think that? Because there's a deer on the bottle.
Duh.
I mean, it's got everything else. Deer blood's like the only thing that ain't in it. Citrus, licorice, anise. I think I'm pronouncing that correctly. Saffron. I'm just wild about saffron.
Most expensive spice in the world. Do you know that?
I believe the people of Arrakis might have a couple of things to say about that. Spice is life, Mary.
Oh, sorry.
Juniper berries, ginseng. That's why you get so much energy when you drink Jaeger.
Yeah.
You're ready to take on the world.
I'm just mad about saffron.
What? Saffron's it mad about saffron?
Mad about me.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought it was wild about saffron. They call me Mellow Yellow, quite rightly. He's in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. We were there the year that Donovan got into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. For people who are at home filling out their who got into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame when Alan was there bingo card.
Donovan,
yes. In the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. You'll notice they nobody's trying
wait,
to...
Huh?
What's that?
They made him wait a while.
Yeah, they did.
For a guy that rocks as hard as Donovan.
Yeah. They said, hey man, we dig all that hurdy-gurdy stuff, but do you have a follow-up? I think Mellow Yellow was after Hurdy-Gurdy Man. And he really planted his flag in that, too. Who else was going to be a Hurdy-Gurdy Man? It was as if he was worried somebody else was going to take that title. Like, there was this wild rush to establish himself as the Hurdy-Gurdy Man. He's like, I don't want anybody else taking this. The music business is cutthroat. I gotta have something that makes me stand out. So mad about saffron. break. If you want to text 35192 to do that, alancoxshow.com, hit us up there and listen wherever.